We were a microcosm of power in New York City. The paper was meant to, was essentially, we constructed it to be an antidote to the New York Times, because the New York Times was so dominant at the time I came to the paper in sending a received wisdom to the city. And nobody was saying, wait a minute, it's a great newspaper, but in the world of the of New York in the 1920s and 30s, of course, there were 8-10 great broadsheets. There were a lot of smart writers, and so the New York Observer was A, meant to diagnose power in New York, B, meant to, in a weird way, provide a Rashomon to the New York Times. And then, of course, the third thing was that it was meant to be tremendous fun and a reminiscence of what newspapers could be when we, during, they were a medium that we loved. And so the, as Carr pointed out in kind of a lovely piece, the cascading headlines of the New York Observer were a comment on the newspaper form itself.
And so where is it today?
It's two editors past me. Actually, Jared Kushner this afternoon, the owner of the New York Observer, has announced at 5 o'clock, he announced there will be a new editor of the paper. I think Jared is positioning it in a place that is a little bit different than where I lived, you know, and Jared's a very focused, interested owner who is, I worked for Arthur Carter and then Jared Kushner as two owners. Jared wants to make sense of the paper as a business, which he has every right to. And so he, I think it's okay for me to say this on television, I hope it is, but he hired a wonderful editor today named Kyle Pope, who is replacing my wonderful replacement, Tom McGivern. And Pope was I think he was executive editor of Portfolio. And he'll begin in December.
Why did you leave?
I thought that I had driven the car as far as it could go, and you know, I wanted to learn something new, and I want to learn something new, and I have a sort of a evangelical mission to save the part of the print media that I love, which is to me sophisticated, arcane, a little bit of throwback to the 20s. But also a 21st century medium that the internet was a direct assault on.